Stuart!
He shouted.
Look at this mess. Did you do this?
No, I haven't been in here.
Stuart.
It wasn't me. It must have been the ghost.
I'm getting a headache. Get me a glass of water.
You're never getting out.
Help!
Why bother? There's no one around for miles. Who's going to hear you?
Help!
Your choice.
Help! 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 It's impossible for you to leave.
I'll wait here for someone to come by and then shout for help. When Tamsin doesn't go into work, someone will come looking for her.
Perhaps. But then what? You've got nowhere left. No one left. Plus two dead bodies to explain. I'm all you have left now.
After I died, she explained it to me. She had passed her suffering on to me and could go. I'm trapped here now, alone.
Stuart! George, I just want to thank you. Thanks for your help. Well, I suppose that's my time up.
George, are you all right?
Yeah. A lot to take in. I suppose I'm relieved in a way. I know what's happened. The ghost has gone.
I'm not sure we're hearing the truth.
Are you calling my son a liar?
No. It's just that.
Just what?
Some things he told us didn't add up. Some things he wouldn't have known.
Like what?
Well, he wasn't around for either of Gillian's encounters with the ghost, was he?
No.
And Stuart told us that he died in the kitchen. Where did you find the body?
Thank you. This can be quite difficult. I think I need to explain a few things. When people die, their spirits are freed from their bodies. And these spirits must then develop to move on through the subsequent spheres of existence. Ultimately, spirits can attain perfection. Well, you've just seen evidence of the afterlife for yourself. You also seem to believe in ghosts. Most mediums contact spirits that have moved on in the belief that they can offer advice for this world. I prefer to contact spirits that are stuck at the first stage. Those that are struggling to move on because of something that happened in life.
So are you saying that's what Stuart is?
Mm. You know, when I first started to discover my talents, I spent some time living in London. Got a sense that a spirit was trying to communicate with me in the room where I was staying. Eventually, I managed to contact him, and he told me that he was Jack the Ripper.
Jack the Ripper?
Yes. I was quite shocked. I wondered whether I should help such a monster.
I think I can help you there. Why on earth would you want to help anybody like that?
That's where it gets interesting. After talking to this spirit on a number of occasions, I managed to find out the truth. He wasn't the Ripper at all. He just thought he was.
If he wasn't the Ripper, why would he think he was?
Guilt. Confusion after death. He was a doctor working at the London hospital. And occasionally, at the end of a late shift, he'd go and visit a prostitute called Polly. One night, he went to see her and saw someone strangling her. And Polly was Jack the Ripper's first victim.
I still don't get it. Why did he think it was the Ripper?
Because he couldn't tell anyone about the attack. He'd recognized the killer. It was a doctor that he knew, and he was scared. Scared of a retaliation if he told anyone, and scared that his wife would find out where he'd been going at night. So each new murder filled him with guilt. Guilt that he had to live with until his dying day, and in death, his guilt became confusion. He saw himself as the Ripper.
So what does that mean to us?
Well, perhaps the same thing that is holding Stuart here is confusing him. I think we need to find out the truth.
Look, I know I've heard the truth. I want you to go. I don't want you to ask any more questions. I don't want you to exorcise the ghost. I don't want you to hate him.
Stuart is still trapped here. Now, I don't want to hurt him or exorcise him. I want to help him move on into the afterlife.
You do that, then. I need some air.
George!
Don't you want to say goodbye?
Feel my phone vibrating.
Answer it next time. I want you to get back here now. The Mackenzies are here waiting.
I've got more to do here.
I can't do this on my own.
But what do you need a medium for if you're just going to use some special effects?
If you don't get back here now, I swear I'll smash your fucking face in!
troubled spirit. We ask that you commune with us and move among us. Troubled spirit. We ask that you commune with us and move among us. Troubled spirit.
Who are you?
My name's Robert. I'm here to
help. Have you seen Stuart?
No.
Sometimes feel like he's here, but can't get to him.
Maybe I can help you with that. But first, I need to know what happened to you.
Do you believe in hell?
No.
Well, you should. Because I've been there.
You mean your home life was troubled?
No. I literally mean hell. I'm a demon.
What do you mean, a demon?
Not your typical kind. A thought demon.
What thought demon?
You know the image of a typical demon in hell. Big, powerful, all brute force. They need others to think for them. To devise new ways to torture.
Well, that's you, is it?
Yes. Sometimes we're allowed up from hell. Mingle with people. Learn that what they fear. Learn their pain.
Tamsin, I'm here to talk about what happened after your dad left. Can you tell me about that?
After he left, we're having problems with money. I wasn't earning much and we missed his wage. Well, we only need to make the minimum payment on this.
Won't we end up paying loads of interest?
Yes, but we need to think about what we can afford to pay now.
What about the electric?
We need to pay that.
Stuart, you're not going to help. Leave us alone. This is important.
Stuart.
Leave him. If he's going to behave like a child, we'll just treat him like one.
We should try and involve him. If you want him to behave like an adult, you've got to start treating him like one. Sorry if Mum shouted at you last night. It wasn't because she's angry with you. We've just got a lot to worry about right now.
She sounded cross with me.
Oh, please don't be upset with her. Why don't we go for a walk? You don't like being cooped up here. See, I knew it'd do you good to get out. This is the real you.
Yeah, this is more fun.
I often had violent thoughts. They had never affected anyone else before, not even Stuart. But since Dad left, it was as though my thoughts were seeping into him. Stuart, what's the matter?
I had a dream about killing Dad.
Just a dream. That's all.
Tamsin, do you remember when we used to come out here washing up bottles filled with water and play soldiers?
Yeah. You'd always sneak up on me and save me.
We should do it again.
Don't you think we're a bit too old for that? Maybe we could do it again. I think I'd be the one soaking you now.
I don't think so.
Stuart, stop it! Be getting back. It's getting dark.
Stuart, that's enough. Stuart.
Tamsin, your relationship with Stuart...
Before you say anything, remember what I am. Remember as well that I was used to looking after him.
Well, I realise that.
No, but... you don't. Stuart was a good kid. It wasn't right in the head. Imagine a kid like that going to school in a backwards fucking place like this. He needed me to fight his battles. And not just at school, either.
Look who I found.
Hi, mate.
Seen my new mobile. Just got it yesterday. Cost a packet.
Yeah? You got one?
Yeah.
What one have you got then?
I can't remember what it's called now.
It's got video messaging. Yeah. Play music.
Yeah.
Does it play games?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? What games has it got then? Has it got Bash the Bishop? That's a good one, isn't it? Do you like bashing the bishop?
I'll bet you bash the bishop every chance you get.
Hey!
I'll bet you bash the bishop every chance you get.
Hey!
What the fuck?
I think it's funny to take the piss out of him.
Who the fuck do you think you are?
I'm his sister.
I know that. So fucking what?
Ah! Leave it!
She's a fucking nutter!
Come on, Stuart.
Fucking weirdos! He's still got my mobile!
Sure, then.
Yeah, they won't be bothering you again.
What are you trying to do to me?
What?
Phoning here, shouting and screaming at me. Were you trying to give me a heart attack?
I didn't.
I knew it was you.
No, I don't think it was him. He was with me all the time.
It wasn't me. It must have been the ghost.
What?
We have a ghost. I've seen her.
Oh, don't be so stupid, Stuart.
She's real. I've seen her.
If you're going to lie like that, get away from me.
Mum. Please go easier on him.
I just really needs to grow up a bit.
Well, I don't think shouting at him helps. What do you mean?
You should be spending more time with friends your own age.
Why'd you say that?
You're growing up. Try and look after us now. This is your chance.
My chance?
You've got to take what you can from this life, Tamsin.
I like spending time with Stuart. He's my friend, as well as my brother.
He's holding you back. You know
he's
is.
He's not holding me back.
Yes, he is. He's been holding us all back since your dad left.
No! I'm not listening to you say that.
I'm just trying to help
you. Yeah, well, you're not helping. You may be ready to give up on him, but I'm not. He needs me. Stuart? Please... don't be upset. Stuart.
You're really here?
Yeah.
You can't touch me. Hmm.
The next morning was uncomfortable. I didn't know how to take it from there.
Thompson?
Stuart, I can't tell anyone about what happened.
Why not?
What we did was wrong. If anyone finds out, they'll separate us. You don't want that, do you? Okay. We've got to make sure that Mum does not find out. We need to be careful. Do you understand? I'd better be quick. Mum will be up soon. I'm gonna get in the shower. She won't suspect anything if she gets up and I'm in the bathroom.
Did you continue to have sexual relations with your brother?
What the fuck? You're putting words in her mouth. Fucking pervert!
Dad, no!
Tamsin,
come here.
No. I'm not who you think I am, Dad.
Why are you then?
I'm a demon.
A demon?
That's why it all happened.
George, maybe I better take over. I was getting somewhere.
I could see where you were getting. What were you trying to get her to say? You can just stay away from her. And shut the fuck up. Don't even think about leaving. Sit there! Tamsin. The ghost.
I never saw a ghost. Stuart was always talking about a ghost in the house. He got so scared he couldn't sleep alone.
See? The boy was frightened. His big sister was looking after him. Nothing more to it than that. Go on.
As I said, I didn't see a ghost. But I was having dreams. Stuart?
Tamsin? Is she dead? I killed her. I don't know why, it just...
I know.
You know.
We need to bury her.
I can't touch her.
Would you rather go to prison? You'll help me. Please.
No. It's not true.
It's true, Dad.
It can't be true. It's not your fault. It was the...
Tamsin, why did you bury the body? Why didn't you call the police?
Who? If we told anyone, Stuart would end up going to prison. Either that or an asylum. I couldn't let that happen.
After what he did, it would have been the right thing to do. He killed someone, Tamsin. And that's a crime.
It's easy to say that people should be punished when you don't know them. It's a bit different if it's your brother. Besides, it wasn't his fault. I'm the one to blame. I put it into his head.
I wanted you to leave this to me. What did you do then?
It wasn't your fault. I know that. Maybe we can get away with this.
Oh.
No one ever comes here, apart from the landlord. If I always take the rent check to him a few days before it's due, maybe we'll be okay. Maybe no one will realise she's gone.
Do you really think we can?
We need to make the most of every day. It'll end at any time. We tried to keep going. But it was never gonna last. I knew that. But I don't think Stuart ever understood it.
Stuart told us that the ghost killed you.
You've seen Stuart? He's here! What did he say?
He told us that the ghost killed you. Is that what happened?
No! It was because of one of my dreams. Stuart, what are you doing? Stuart! Stuart! Stuart!
She blames me. Those thoughts she had. Beating me. The family needed me. I should never have left.
I still don't think we're hearing the truth. At least not all of it.
We know the truth. It was the ghost.
That's not what Tamsin said. Think about it. Now, Stuart and Tamsin both told us things that didn't make sense, but there were parallels in their stories. The truth is in there somewhere.
Don't give me that shit.
I thought you wanted to know the truth.
Yes. Show me the truth. Get the ghost.
I can't guarantee.
Summon her. Summon her now. Before I fucking kill you, hear?
Wouldn't.
There's no one for miles around. Remember that. Summon her! Well, go on then.
Please. Stand in the corner.
No. I'm staying.